Hello students and welcome back to the video lecture series of web programming. Today's topic is CSS radial gradients. I am your instructor Ms. Shruti Rawal. So if you recall, in the last lecture we had discussed about what do you mean by gradients in CSS, what are the different types. There were two types, CSS linear gradient and CSS radial gradient. So in the last lecture we have already discussed what is CSS linear gradient and the properties as well as the syntax about CSS linear gradient. In today's lecture, we are going to further discuss what do you mean by CSS radial gradient. So, a radial gradient is defined by its center. If you recall the linear gradient, it was specified either top to bottom, left to right, or diagonally. Whereas, you have only one option in radial gradient, it is defined from the center, and you must create a radial gradient again by specifying minimum two color stop. It starts from the center and it goes towards the edges. But how does it cover the edges? It covers the edges by default in an oval shape. So the transitions that you will be seeing in the radial gradient, because radial is basically dedicated to the radius. Okay, so it means that you will have some sort of circular view in your web page. And that is, you will by default have an oval. If you want, you can specify the circle also. So here you can see that I have the syntax. Again, the property name is background-image. Instead of writing inside the property value linear-gradient, it is just replaced by radial-gradient. Inside that, there are multiple parameters that you can specify. The first one is shape, the second one is size, position, start color, and the last color. Okay, so by default I told you the shape is ellipse, size is the farthest corner, and the position is by default center. Okay, and evenly spaced color stop it will have. If you want, you can specify unevenly spaced color stop as well. So here you can see, this is an example that is the by default format of radial gradient. It starts from the center, it follows the transition of the colors that you have specified. It looks like an ellipse, that there is an ellipse which you can see visually, and in that ellipse you can see the transition from the center, that is red color to green color, and it is a very smooth transition to look at. Okay. Now let us study what all manipulation you can do using this radial gradient property. So you can see over here that I have again one division, and I have specified an ID called grade grad1, and again I have specified the height of that division, width of that division. By default, if it does not support gradients, what will be the color that will be displayed, which I have written red. And if it supports a radial gradient, then I have specified the property. I told you the property name again, it is background-image. Inside the property value, I have written radial-gradient. Inside that, I told you that you should have minimum two spots, that is color stop. Here I have specified three color stop. Starting from the center, it will take the color till the outer edges. So the first color in the center will be yellow, the first color will be red, second will be yellow, and third will be green. So this will be the output that you can see. Okay, so these are the evenly spaced color stop. Now for CSS radial gradient, can you specify the proportion of each color? That what is the proportion of red color, what is the proportion of yellow color, what is the proportion of green color? Yes, we can do so. So here you can see I have specified that for my transition I should have the proportion of red color only 5%, yellow 15%, and green 60%. So you will be visually able to see minimum color, that is red, that will be only 5% visible on the screen. Yellow will be 15% visible on the screen, and the maximum color that you may be able to see, because you have specified green as 60%, will be the green color. Okay, let us see how you can see. So here you can see that red is only being able to see for a small portion, that is 5%, yellow is 15%, and green is taking maximum of your web screen, that is 60%. So here you can see that it is not evenly spaced color stop. Instead of that default evenly spaced color stop, you have different proportion of each color and you are differently spacing the color stops. The next in CSS gradient is this is the simple CSS gradient and this is the CSS gradient in which you are specifying that my shape should be circle. By default I told you it takes an ellipse shape. If you want to explicitly change the shape, you can specify circle. So here you can see the difference. The first one is a little bit oval, or you can say ellipse the shape, whereas the second one is circle. So by default, if you do not specify the shape, it takes ellipse. If you specify explicitly circle, it will have a view of circle. The next is, as we have seen in linear gradient, that we can repeat the linear gradient. Similar thing can be applied in radial gradient as well. You can repeat the radial gradient. So if you want to specify repeating radial gradient, you can see over here I have specified, again the property name is background hyphen image, the property value is repeating hyphen radial hyphen gradient. Inside that I have specified three color stop. The first one is red, the second one is yellow, which is taking 10%, and the third one is green, which is taking 15%. So you can see that I have differently spaced the proportion of the color, as well as I am not having only one linear one radial gradient. Instead I want this radial gradient to repeat itself. So what will be the output? This will be the output. The transition will be one time, two time, three time, as much as time it as it can cover the whole division. Okay, so this was repeating radial gradient, and this was all about CSS radial gradient, and this was all about today's lecture. Thank you.